Hello, my name's Richard, as you know from that awkward video I did earlier. You've probably seen this tree around. It's used quite a lot in our branding. And the thing with the tree is I was trying to come up with some kind of metaphor for today's presentation with the tree, and I realized that actually those five branches at the bottom, or the five bits of the trunk, were very useful for me. If you look at the tree as all of the adult learning professionals out there in Europe and across the world, of which there are many, you can look at it as various communities across the wider adult learning professionals community. You have communities of national and local associations and projects and programs. You have communities at both at local national level, but also at European level, previous programs and projects that have been launched by the European Commission and others. You have lots of communities outside of Europe, of course, and US is very active, particularly on social media and LinkedIn. There are some very large LinkedIn groups around adult learning from the US. And of course, you have on social media other smaller niche communities that spring up around hashtags and around Facebook groups and LinkedIn groups and all sorts of other places. The thing is, until now, there's never been really one digital space for adult learning professionals in Europe. They've been very fragmented, and we're hoping that the EPALE community will address this, because it's really the first digital space, it's a multilingual community, an open community that anybody can register for and contribute to. And I'll show you some of the features in a second. But I mentioned this was quite fortuitous, because we have five thematic groups, and the five themes are really what drives the EPALE community. You heard earlier the thematic coordinators, and those, I'm just going to test this. Wow, that's nice. Those thematic coordinators blog for those five groups, and you'll see them coming up and resonating throughout the rest of the site, because you have as a basis the five groups, but they of course include a lot of niche topics within them. Now, on the actual site, I hope everybody's seen the site by now, but this is what the groups, or how the themes are presented on the site. Actually, that was updated a few days ago, so because we're constantly evolving the site, there's thematic pages now, so you've got the five themes presented with a little bit more information. But next to that, you can see the community activities, and those community activities include events, news, blog, and resource center. Now, first with the event calendar. The event calendar has been around for a while. It was launched a few months ago, in fact, and we've been adding events to it, not only the CSS, but now the National Support Services are adding contributing events. There was an update the other day, so not only can you search for events according to day or week or month, you can also search past events. Everything is tagged, so you can search according to tag, according to location, etc. So that's the event page or the event calendar. And remember, this is open to all of you to contribute if you have events to contribute. The newsroom brings together news, as the name suggests, from around Europe. And because it's multilingual, it's really the only place where you can find everything in one spot. It's really much, very much a hub for news in the adult learning sector. The blog, I would say, is one of the more important parts of the site, particularly in the early days, because it's the blog that really drives the thematic groups. As I said, the thematic coordinators are blogging on each of their respective five themes. And we recently opened up the blog to other guest bloggers to also publish their material. So it's probably a good opportunity to put out the call to those here. If you feel that you have something to say and you would like to blog about it on the EPALE site, you're very welcome to submit your material. Just contact the help desk and they'll have a chat with you about that. The Resource Centre, it was launched quite recently, a few weeks ago, this particular feature, and we've already got about 1,000 resources on the site. So resources from across Europe. You can see that the resources are tagged, as everything else is on the site, and the tag cloud, I mean, you'll see there as an example, but You've got tags by the main themes, but also by some niche topics, topics that you might not be able to find very easily elsewhere, such as, let's say, prison education. You can also search the tags according to some of the stakeholders and the other players who are involved in the site. So the resource center is really important for us. Now, I've introduced very quickly, and that was a very brief introduction, to the features of the site, but I'm the community manager, so you're probably wondering, where's the actual community? Now, we set up, this is just a hypothetical user profile, but we already have quite a few users who've registered. For those who have not registered, could you just put your hand up if you have not registered for a user profile? Don't be shy. Well, it's pretty good. So most of you have registered. I'd encourage those who haven't registered, just go to the tab. It's in the top right of the site of the homepage, and you can register very quickly. So this is Eva Pale, as in EPALE. She's added a brief bio, type of organization she works for, her role in the organization, translation skills, which can be useful down the track if we want to translate important pieces of content into other languages. We're hoping our users can help us with that. So how can Eva connect with the community? I'm glad you asked. These are the community activities at the moment that she can connect with the community with. So you're able to rate Eva and yourselves, anybody who has a user profile who's registered, you're able to rate blog posts, events, news items, items in the resource center, the resource center. You're also able to comment on the blog. You'll be able to comment as well on the partner search, which I'll talk about in a second. You're able to contribute, not just a blog post, which I mentioned earlier, but you can contribute news items. You can contribute the event calendar, which a lot of people are doing already. In fact, you can't contribute news items at the moment. It's very much for the national and national partners and the CSSs, but we might open that up as well. In the future, in the very near future, you'll be able to start a forum. So you can go to any of the thematic groups, and perhaps you're interested in starting a conversation around one particular niche aspect of the themes. You'll be able to start that forum from the thematic groups. Very soon, you'll also be able to find partners. And I think particularly from the online community and from speaking to people so far, it's the one feature that they've been waiting for the most. The partner search will be implemented very soon, this month is foreseen, and you'll be able to look for partners, as the name suggests, and of course, on social media, we've been around for a few months, we're on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. If you're not following us there, please do so. Now, there are four users that we identified. We got a lot of material from the National Support Services, and thanks to them for that. There was all sorts of stuff that we got, but we decided to choose just four user testimonials. I won't call them actually testimonials. They're just users talking about their early experiences with the site. So remember that today's the official launch, so and a lot of the features are quite new, so there's not, until now, all that much content to work with, but there's still enough for users to get some value out of it. So I'll just play these very quickly. Our first one is from the UK. There are a couple from the Netherlands, and there's also one from Poland.
Hi, my name's Daniel Sellers. I'm a freelance education consultant. My background is in adult learning policy and practice with the specialisms of numeracy and financial capability. I first heard about EPALE at a contact seminar for the Erasmus Plus program. It was particularly useful in the past month or two as I was helping to coordinate putting an Erasmus Plus funding bid into the UK National Agency to get the latest news on policy and practice and events around Europe. I think that anything like this that gives adult learning professionals a sense of community is important. We all need to stick together and shout loud about the difference that adult learning makes, especially at times when funding is in the balance across a large part of the European community.
I've recently become involved in adult education in our company. I now have to teach people about certain procedures at work in a language that is not my own. Although I know everything about the subject itself, I have not been formally trained in didactics or things like that. It would be very useful if EPALE can help me and my company with some assistance or as a starting point.
Hi, my name is Hubert Skrzyński. I come from Poland and I'm the teacher of English. I teach English in a prison. I'm a prison educator. I'm the head of a prison of one of the schools in Poland. And I have an honor to be an ambassador of EPALE platform, so I cooperate with NSS. Why EPALE platform is important for me? The thing is that prison education is one of the weakest fields of education in Poland. That's why I needed to try and look for people who work in the same field of education as I do. Plus, I need to find proper resources to develop myself at work.
Hopefully it will be practice oriented and we'll have a combination that also researchers, policymakers and professionals will meet each other virtually and also can use the resources of the last years concerning adult education in Europe.